the main event, I think there was a passing of the torch tonight. Tomasi Dembick has had an amazing career. I don't know what he's going to do. He asked to leave. He wanted to go home. He has to get a lot of ice in his face. He has a lot of swelling, a lot of abrasions. But he's with his people. They're taking care of him now. And tonight, this gentleman here to my left emerged and showed that he did absolutely everything he had to do to win a fight against a very tough, very accomplished opponent, a guy who's a legitimate top 10 heavyweight for the last 6-7 years. I think he announced his arrival tonight and made it very clear to everyone that he belongs in the top 5 in the heavyweight division. He's going to be at the top of the heavyweight division for a very long time. His defense is absolutely amazing. His offense he showed tonight, incredible. He just kept coming, and I'm a little at a loss to know who amazed me more, whether it was Czar and the fight plan he executed, the amazing performance he made, or whether it was a Dembick that just kept coming and coming. They both deserve all of our respect and love. So, does anybody want to make a speech? You're all meant a few words. Do you want to say anything?
Well, I can just say, want to thank our hard work and preparation for this bout, which is our first bout was canceled, as everybody knows. We waited another 3 months or 4 months until it was scheduled the next one. Fortunately, we got in the last time to fight the guy. He came in as an exchange for Tomasz Adamek in a 2-day, and this time the fight happened. I think today heavyweight division is not as excited as it used to be 10 years ago or 12 years ago. And people like Vyacheslav Glazkov, Czar, are going to start to bring it back, those heavy days.
Czar, would you like to say anything?
Да, хочу поблагодарить компанию Main Events, Katie Doo. В частности, хочу поблагодарить телеканал NBC Sport, казино Sands. Я думаю, что, конечно же, Томаша Адамека за этот, как я думаю, прекрасный поединок. Еще хочу в особенности поблагодарить моего второго сопромоутера, это Кирилла Пчельникова из Москвы, который дал мне толчок в профессиональном боксе.
I wanted to thank the company Main Events, Cafe Duva, for giving this opportunity and taking me to this road. I wanted to thank Television Network NBC. I wanted to thank Sands Casino for giving this opportunity and hosting us. And I wanted to thank Tomasz Adamek, who gave me this opportunity, who took a bout because he was risking more than I did. And I also wanted to thank my another co-promoter who is in Russia, Kirill Chelnikov, the co-promotion company called Pushka. He's the one guy who started me as a professional boxer in Russia.
И персональная благодарность, конечно же, моему менеджеру, любимому Эйсу Климасу, который вывел меня на американский ринг. У нас с ним прекрасные отношения, и со всеми ребятами я общаюсь, которые в нашей команде, у нас дружный коллектив. Это все благодаря Эйсу.
And special thanks to my trainer.
No, and trainer too.
And a special thanks to my manager, who I have a very good relationship, and who helped me to come here to this road and brought me here to this place.
Do we have questions?
How would he rate his performance tonight? I know he looks like he's the guy that might have lost, but how does he rate his performance tonight?
Как ты оцениваешь свою
поединок? Я думаю, мы провели зрелищный поединок, как я и обещал. Томаш не из тех бойцов, которые идут назад. Он показывает открытый бокс. Соответственно, у нас вышел, по моему мнению, красивый зрелищный бой.
I think the performance was very good. Tomas is not the guy who was backing up, he was coming forward, and I think it was a very, very good bout.
And a classic case of you should have seen the other guy. It's a classic case of you should have seen the other guy.
Yes. That one is not showing up?
He came and the press was out watching the fight and he was waiting a while and he asked if he could go. He went home. He's all beat up. He's got ice on everything. I understand this.
Yeah. Yes, was there any fight in particular that you studied of Adam's career that prepared you for this fight?
Був какой-то спеціальний бой, который ты рассмотрел, потому что Адам, из которого ты учился с ним воевать на этот бой?
Я просмотрел его все последние поединки, ну и, конечно же, большой опыт приобрел в спаррингах, когда спарринговал с ним. Поэтому я ждал, что от него ожидать. И мы с моим тренером Эдуардом Нищиковым делали заготовки на этот поединок.
I watched last of his fights, and I studied last of his fights, but I think the more opportunity I get, because I had to spar with him, and with my trainer, Eduard, we made the game plan according to my sparrings and to his last bout.
When was the last time you sparred?
Это было в августе 2013
года. August
2013.
As early as the second round, his eyes started to blow up, and you know there were times of the fight, at least looking from our vantage point, you know he looked like maybe he could have been ready to go. Did you think at any point in the fight that you were going to be able to get him out of there?
Ты начал как бы газовать со второго раунда, и как бы что-то некоторые моменты не думал, что ты можешь его остановить в котором третьем раунде.
Да, были такие моменты. Я видел, что мои удары его сильно потрясли. Как говорится на боксерском языке, качнулся, пошатнулся, но здесь сыграл большой опыт и стойкость Томаша Адамаха. Он стойкий боец, и несмотря на пропущенные удары, он всегда остается на ногах и опасен в эти моменты.
Yes, I cut him a couple times, and I saw, I shook him down. I think that was an experience of his boxing career where he got away.
What, going into this fight, if you're weighing your pluses and your minuses, what did you think your best plus was going into this fight, your biggest advantage?
Что ты думаешь, какой самый большой плюс был, если ты сейчас рассматриваешь вот этот бой, как ты думаешь, какой самый большой плюс был для тебя?
Это, конечно же, дистанция 12 раундов, и немаловажную роль здесь играл сам Томаш Адамак. Я перенял его опыт поединка.
Did you ask him about going into it or from this bout?
Yes, in other words, when you were mapping out your strategy for this fight, which advantage do you think you had the best advantage in? Which category?
Когда ты готовился к этому бою, как ты думаешь, что самое лучшее было для тебя? Что ты видел самое лучшее в этой подготовке?
Ну, у меня вообще подготовка состояла из трех этапов. Еще хочу отдельную благодарность выразить городу Самаре. Я туда ездил три недели. Работал с тренером Дмитрия Пирога, Виктором Николаевичем Петроченко. Получил там определенную профессиональную школу, которую пытался применить в ринге. Ну, конечно, хочу выразить благодарность Underground Boxing Gym во главе с Ильей Мезенчев, который помог нам в подготовке к этому поединку.
It was a few steps preparing for me for this fight, and I was still in Ukraine. I went to a city called in Russia, city called Samara, and I was preparing with a trainer who trained Dmitry Pirog. Петриченко, Виктор Петриченко. He showed me some little tricks or whatever we call it. I wanted to thank him. And then I came here to the United States. I was preparing in Brooklyn at the gym called Underground, who's owned by Ilya Mizilchev. I wanted to thank him, and that's what I think was the best.
Thank you. I got a question. When you were seen to be throwing, you were hurting him well with the left jabs and straight lefts, and if you would miss, you would hold it on his shoulder, and it seemed to block Adamek's right hands from coming over. Was that one part of the game plan, is to make sure you just could keep that from coming in the early rounds? He looked like about the fourth round, he wasn't even throwing right hands long in the place.
Коли ти йому джебували, і зразу як-то заходив, як би прихватив його праву руку, то була у тебе така підготовка, щоб він не мог тебе ударити правою рукою. Так,
да, Томаш швидкий боєць, він завжди може ударити ответний удар, тому пытався блокувати його праву руку, щоб не отримати відповідь.
Yeah, he's a very fast fighter, and he can hit on my when I'm coming into it. So I was always trying to block his right hand.
Zara, it was a great fight tonight. Great ball in the ring. You actually reminded me of the young Thomas.
What?
What's next for you in
очень хороший боец, очень хороший бой. Мне понравился, ты мне напомнил молодого Томаша Адамека, что следующее для тебя тяжелый вес.
Хочу, конечно же, боксировать за звание, потому что иначе бы я не занимался профессиональным боксом. И я уже не знаю, как решит федерация IBF, по которой разыгрывалось второе место, или будет иллюминатор, поэтому на чемпионский поединок, или, как мне хочется, конечно, сразу побоксировать за звание чемпиона.
Of course, I wanted to fight for the world title. Otherwise, I wouldn't be fighting in a boxing ring. This is my dream. And I don't know what's the IBF going to do. Do they want me to fight for the eliminator, or might be possibility for me to fight for world title?
What do you think was your biggest advantage over this fight, such as speed? And was he everything that you expected?
Что ты думаешь, что было самое лучшее для тебя в этом бою? Может, скорость? И what is the next question?
Was Adamek everything that he expected?
Ты все, Адамек был все, что ты ожидал от него?
В принципе, да. Адамек показал хорошую форму, всегда задавали вопросы по поводу его возраста, но я всегда отвечал, что не надо делать скидку на его возраст. Он хорошо сложен, он показал отличную скорость, он показал отличную выносливость. Но опять-таки, повторюсь, я с ним спарринговал, и я знал, что от него ожидать.
Yes, I think he showed what he could. And everybody was talking about his age, which is I always never concerned about it. He's a great fighter. He showed a very good bout, and I think that's what I was expecting.
How good did it feel for him to fight the way that he fought tonight, especially in light of the way that the Malik Scott fight went? And what does he think he showed people that he didn't show people in that fight?
Как для тебя это хорошо, что ты пробоксировал этот бой, и что ты думаешь, что ты показал людям, что ты не смог показать в бою с Маликом Скаттом?
Я благодарен судьбе, что у меня был поединок с Маликом Скаттом. Мы сделали вывод с моим тренером. У нас была неправильная подготовка к тому поединку. Я был зажат. И поэтому в последующих моих поединках я уже готовился по-другому, и к Томашу Адамеку также мы прошли другую подготовку.
I'm very glad the bout came out with Malik Scott in my career. I learned a lot. I think preparation for the bout for Malik Scott wasn't as we expected to be. I was kind of like tied up very much. And of course, Malik Scott is a different fighter than Tomas Adamek, he was running. But I think we learned a lot from the fight of Malik Scott. And that's what we and my trainer worked on it and got some results.
Question for you, Kathy. How likely is it that we see an IBF eliminator between Czar and Kubrat Pulev in the United States?
I don't think that will happen because I believe Pulev is already, I think Klitschko's already been ordered to fight Pulev. So chances are this number two position is going to be for the next time around.
Okay.
With a lot of interesting things. Yes?
There's a lot of up and coming fighters coming from the Ukraine. You got Lomachenko, you got Vitaly Kopalenko, yourself. How would you describe the state of Ukrainian boxing today?
Как ты видишь украинский бокс? Много сейчас боксеров приезжает. И Коваленко приехал, и Ломаченко, и ты. Как ты можешь сказать, что такое украинский бокс?
Ну что сказать, после развала Советского Союза в 91-м наши боксеры получили возможность заниматься профессиональным боксом, и сейчас мы видим результаты. Сергей Ковалев, чемпион мира, выходец с России, с бывшего Советского Союза, и Градович, все мы вот в одной команде, они чемпионы мира. Подтягивается молодое поколение украинское, это Ломаченко. Да, тоже мы все в одной команде, и я думаю, что мировые вершины будут за нашими ребятами.
After the Soviet Union broke in 1991, we had our countries had the chance to start professional boxing, and right now, as you can see, a lot of fighters from ex-Soviet Union as well as Russia, like Sergey Kovalev, Gradovich, myself, Lomachenko, which is we're all in under the same management team. We're upcoming good fighters. I think right now people enjoying our fight.
Советская школа она очень хорошая, и если к ней добавить элементы профессионального бокса, то это будет гремучая смесь.
The amateur school of Soviet Union is very good, and if you add some more professionalism in it, I think that's going to become a very great fighter.
Does the conflict in the Ukraine motivate him in any way? Does that make him want to fight harder for his country?
Конфликт, который происходил сейчас на Украине, как-то нибудь тебя еще подвинул вперед, как бы заставил тебя драться больше за это?
Да, конечно, я после поединка сказал в камеру, что победу посвящаю Украине и хочу, чтобы люди на Украине не воевали и не погибали люди. Поэтому хочу, чтобы у нас была дружная страна.
Yes, of course, right after the fight I told to cameras and to reporters right in the ring. This bout is for my country, this bout is for Ukraine. I don't want people to get into war there. I want people to live in peace, and especially innocent people not to die.
Yeah, question for Don. Where do you rate Czar in terms of the other, you know, young up-and-coming heavyweights you've worked with over your long career?
Heavyweights that I've worked with?
Yeah.
He's right in there. He's throw more punches, he would be there. You know, they're not overwhelming over him, though.
Okay. Everybody, I want to thank our host here at the Sands. I want to thank my promotional partner, Kirill Chelnik of Krushka, who helped make this meal possible. I want to thank you. I want to thank Don Turner and his crew. And the man here, Czar Glasnov, who is going to be quite a force in the heavyweight division. So I want to thank Tomasz Demick, Zygmunt Zalewski, Roger Woodworth, and the same team. It's been an incredible show, and I thank you all for coming, and we'll see you the next time. And this is Sports Network, it's on a show.
And we wanted to thank all of us.
Hey, John, I got a question.
Thank you.